Battle Ovens and Staggers are almost things of the past. There isn't many places using them today in the potteries. I'm Ralph Wielden and I'm one of the four last Sagger makers. The Saggers are to protect the ware in the bottle ovens during the firing. They say the proper name is a safeguard, and I'm never known to be called any other, only a Sagger. The maul comes in loads, 6 or 7 ton at a time. Probably have 3 ton of sides and 3 ton of bottoms. The bottoms has got bigger grog in and more grog in. We cut the bats off the side maul, and each one, as you throw it on the frame, has to be lapped over at least 1 inch to 1.5 inches to make sure that they're well knitted together. After that you trim it as near as possible as you can to the thickness of the frame. Bill uses a grafter to cut his dumps of maul, and he has to cut them as near as he can to the proper weight, because you've only got to have them a thickness to the ring. Before you start mowing, you scatter it with sawdust, and that helps it from sticking. These mows, what we use, are made of oak, and they have to be soaked in water, because if you don't soak them in water, when you're mowing, the maul will stick to it. Anyhow, when you're mowing the frame in, you start from the back, and as you're mowing, you pull down it and pull sideways, and every part of the maul as you mow, you'll notice the mow goes over where you first started, until you get to the end of the frame, and then you know as the frame is solid, and this is the side of your sack. After you've mowed your frame in, you get your measuring stick, and you've got various heights, and you mark them off with your knife, and you've got to see as they're level. After you've marked them off, you use your rule for cutting out. Now once you put the rule on, and it's got to be on the lines as you've marked, you've got to hit the rule to make sure the suction of the maul holds the rule, because if you get one end higher or lower, then you've got what they call a miscut. So you have to hold it dead level, and then you cut through each marking as you've done, and that is the sides of your sacket. You've got 8 minutes to fill the frame and mow it in and cut it out. Bill, after he's knocked the bottom, gets an iron plate and pulls the bottom onto the plate, and he puts it onto the wheelie, ready for the sagger maker, is going to roll the side of the sagger off the frame and put it onto the bottom. started when I was 14, bottom knocking. And that was bottom knocking for two saga makers, and then you had a frame fella. And you used to have to keep at least 5 to 6 bottoms in front of the saga makers. Because if they were waiting, you'd only got one, and the other saga maker hadn't got a bottom to put on his wheelie, then you were for it. And you got a real good cossie. It takes 3 minutes to knock a bottom. It was £1 a week when I started. A frame fella was on £2, and the top saga maker would be on about £7, £8. Of course, in them days, you had to wait for a saga maker to die before you could get on the wheelie. Because nearly every pot bank carried one or two, some carried three, four. All your tools are made by yourself. You use pieces of oak wood, and you cut them to the shape and sizes as you want. You have what they call a topping stick, which you make out of wood. You have what they call a topping tool, that is ten, strong ten. Years ago we used to use the old Coleman's mustard signs ten. But now today, like, you can get the pieces of ten strong stuff off the firm as you make the topping tools with. The piece of wood as I'm battering top of the saga with is to just show us the top of the saga is level. After it's battered and you've lifted it on the head, then you take it into the otters for dry. My last job is, when they are dry, to take them out to the saga house for the places to handle. Hoist I'd got £1 for every saga as I'd made, because I've done 47 years at it.